here is the iPhone version of the Mogees app. I'm going to get my Mogees and take off the cap and stick it to this little briefcase. It needs to be attached very firmly, so much so that it should have quite a bit of resistance if you try to take it back off. And remember, if the sticky pad gets dirty and loses its adhesiveness, you can just peel it off, wash it under some water, and wait for it to dry before putting it back on. So I'm first going to plug it into my phone. And I've already got my speaker cable connected here. I've already registered my Mogees, so I'm just going to choose login at the bottom and enter my email and password. Don't worry, you won't have to do this every time that you use the app. The first thing that I want to do after I plug my Mogees and speakers in is to set my levels. So I'm going to set the master output of my phone just above halfway. And I'm also going to make sure that my sensitivity is somewhere around in the middle. This will change depending on your setup, but those are good places to start. When you first open the app, there will be an interactive walkthrough, and this covers basically the same content as what we'll be covering here. So now I'm in the untrained kind of plug and play free mode. Basically, the louder that I play, the higher the pitch. And I can choose between some of the default scenes up here. So with Mogees, you can assign different types of hits or strikes to play different notes or sounds. First though, you need to train the app to recognize these different types of taps or hits. We call these different types of strikes or scratches, we call them gestures. So I want my first gesture to be tapping my thumb on the side of this briefcase, and I want that to trigger a kick drum. So now I'm going to press the plus icon. Up here we've got our sound engines, so I'm going to select Interpolate Await. And I'm going to scroll down to our kick drum sound and select next. So now I need to record at least 12 examples of this gesture. And it's very important that only one dot appears each time I hit the side. So if more than one dot is appearing, then you'll have to go back to your advanced settings and increase the trigger threshold. However, if no dots are appearing, then you might want to go and decrease your trigger threshold. The trigger time slider sets the number of onsets that will be detected within a certain number of milliseconds. So if I'm playing on a rattly or wobbly surface like a cymbal or something that shakes a lot, or I notice that re-triggering causes additional dots to appear, I may want to increase the trigger time so that it only recognizes my hit and not the object shaking afterward. The gate slider affects the Blue Steel and Muon sound engines, so you may want to look at these if you're having any feedback problems, you might want to increase it, or if you really want to pick up the most sensitive light touches, you can reduce this all the way down. Okay, so I'm going to go back and record my first gesture again. And I'm going to provide it with a good few taps, giving it a variety of amplitudes and playing around the area, not always exactly on the same spot. And when I'm happy, I'm going to choose done. So this red circle now represents my first gesture, so I can click on it and change any of the sound presets if I wish. So now I'm going to record a second gesture. In order to be recognized as distinct, gestures need to be quite different from one another. So I'm going to use this ring on my finger and associate it with the snare drum sound. So again, I'm going to hit plus. I'm going to go and choose a snare drum sound from Interpolate 08. So now I'm going to start training the sound of my ring on the side of the case. And I'm going to give it some dynamics, just as if I were performing. And now I've got two gestures. So let's add a third gesture. Let's scratch the surface of the briefcase and get a low sound with the Muon sound engine. Okay, so now I've got three. So So now I'm going to train a fourth gesture. I'm going to try my knuckle on the corner of the briefcase. So I'm going to hit plus again. This time I'm going to use blue steel. I'm going to get something nice and high pitched. I can also go into advanced and change the sound parameters for this preset. I'm going to hit next and again record a bunch of examples, giving it a variety of amplitudes and playing around the area that I want to play. So as I said earlier, it's important that gestures sound unique to the sensors so that they are identifiable as unique to the software. So if I were to tap around the same area in the same way, then we'll see that these circles will actually end up overlapping. So since the circles are overlapping, this means that the software will have a hard time telling them apart. So I'm going to hold down on that last gesture until an X appears, and then I'm going to delete it. So instead of using this area again with my knuckle, I'm going to tap the side, which has a different material and should sound different enough. I'm going to go back to blue steel again, actually, and... let's train it up. So now the circles are separate enough, so it should be able to identify them. So now I've got five gestures and I can play what I want.